Hidden within your iPhone, there are certain settings that you should change right now for a better experience. Hey guys, I'm Rahul from Tech Review Pro, and let's get started with the first iPhone setting that you should change right now. Number one, enable dark mode. Your iPhone has a dark mode setting that you can use to reduce eye strain and also increase your battery life. To enable this, head over to the settings menu, then under display and brightness, you'll find the options to switch between light and dark mode. Additionally, you can also set the modes to switch automatically according to the time. Number two, enable low data mode. You can enable low data mode to restrict the background data use on your device, and this can be very useful if you have a limited data plan. To enable this, simply go to settings menu, then under mobile service, tap on mobile data options and then tap on data mode. Now you get these options, so select the one that says low data mode, and your iPhone has low data mode enabled now. Number three, change text size. If you feel that the default text size on your iPhone is insufficient, you can change it by following a few simple steps. First, go into settings menu, then under display and brightness, tap on text size. Then use this slider to adjust the text size according to your preferences. And once you are done with that, exit the menu. Number four, adjust touch brightness. The default flashlight or touch brightness can be too bright or dim in certain situations, but thankfully you can adjust the brightness according to your preference. To do that, open the control center, then tap and hold onto the touch icon, then adjust the slider. Once done, simply exit the menu. Number five, enable optimized battery charging. Since iOS 13, a setting known as optimized battery charging has been included on iPhones. With this setting enabled, your iPhone learns and analyzes your daily charging habits to extend the lifespan of your battery by delaying charging past 80% in certain situations. To enable this, open the settings menu, then under battery, go into the battery health and charging options, and here enable optimized battery charging. Number six, full screen incoming calls. Since the introduction of iOS 14, Apple has changed the way incoming calls are shown on your screen. Earlier, it used to cover the entire screen, and you could do nothing on your iPhone until the call was ringing. But now it shows up as a small banner at the top of your screen. If you are not a fan of this, then you can revert to the full screen caller ID screen. To revert to the old setup, open the settings menu, then scroll all the way down and tap on apps. Now you are in the app settings. Simply scroll until you see phone and tap on that to enter phone settings. Here, tap on incoming calls and next choose full screen to get the old style caller ID screen back. Number seven, silence unknown callers. If you are like me and hate getting calls from telemarketers, spammers, or other unknown people, then you can use this setting to silence the calls automatically. To enable the settings for silencing unknown callers, go to settings, then scroll all the way down and select apps. And after that, scroll a bit and select phone to enter into phone settings options. Here, scroll down a bit and you'll see the option to silence unknown callers. Tap on that and turn on the toggle switch to enable the silence unknown callers option. Number eight, change Siri's voice. If you don't like the default voice of Siri, then you can change it. Head over to the settings menu, then tap on Siri to enter Siri settings. Now from these options, tap on voice and then select the other available voice tone according to your preference. Number nine, schedule notification summary. You can schedule a fixed time to receive a summary of your notifications for the day so that you don't miss out on any of the important ones. The notifications are arranged according to your usage of the apps, and the most used apps notifications will be shown first and so on. To enable this, go to settings, then tap on notifications, and it'll take you to the notification settings on your iPhone. Here, select the option that says scheduled summary, then turn on the toggle switch to enable the notification summary. However, please note that this is only available for the devices running on iOS 15 and later. Number 10, disable app tracking. iPhone already takes your privacy very seriously, but if you want to further enhance your privacy, then you can choose to disable activity tracking across apps by other companies. To do that, simply go to settings, then under privacy and security, go into the tracking menu and here disable the allow apps to request to track option. When you disable this, all new app tracking requests are automatically denied and you get even more privacy. Number 11, enable back tap. Did you know you can double tap or triple tap on the back of your iPhone to perform certain tasks? Yes, you can enable the back tap feature to perform tasks such as muting your iPhone, opening the control center and more. To enable this, go to the settings menu and then tap on accessibility. After that, scroll a bit and select touch. Now scroll down and there you will see back tap. Tap on that and then set it up according to your preference depending upon what task you want your iPhone to perform on, double or triple tap on the back. Number 12, change default browser. If for some reason you don't like the default web browser on your iPhone, you may choose to set a different default browser other than Safari for your web browsing needs. Just head over to the settings menu, then scroll to the bottom and select apps. After that, find and select the option that says Safari. Now we are in the app settings of Safari and here you can see default browser app settings. So tap on that and choose a different browser that you want to set as the default web browser on this iPhone. And number 13, change default mail app. Similarly, you can change the default mail app to any other app rather than using Apple Mail. To change your default mail app on your iPhone, head over to the settings menu, then scroll to the bottom and select apps. Now here in the app settings, find and select the mail app. Then tap on the default mail app option and choose another email app that you want to set as the default mail app on your iPhone. Well, this brings us to the end of this video. But don't go away, as you can simply tap on this video to learn which iPhone settings you should never change. And by the way, that is very important, so make sure you watch that.